Alright everybody, this is Monkey Puzzle, and this is a brand new game. Well, actually it's not completely new, this is Alpha Playtest 6.0 of Worlds Adrift, but it's completely new to me because I've never played it. So hello to everybody who just entered the stream, let me know if you guys can hear me alright, and we're going to start this in just a second. So yeah, Worlds Adrift is a very cool game. It's a sandbox MMO, and there's a bunch of floating islands. Basically, the world has blasted apart, and your job as the character is to make it from island to island and make flying ships, flying airships, and use them to go to more islands and make bigger airships. And it is all in sort of a PvP context. You don't have to fight each other, but you certainly can. So you gotta watch out for that. So even if you are a peaceful type like me, you gotta watch your back. So like I said, it's an alpha right now. This is, can I give you a shout out? So we are streaming this, and I'm gonna be talking with the folks in the chat at the same time. So right now we've got Nathaniel 12343 and Blazing Ninja MC. So they're the first two to join. We got six people in the stream so far. So I will be talking to people as we go along. But I'm gonna have to focus here because this is the first time I've ever played, and I have a little bit of idea what to do, but it is brand new to me. So okay, folks say that they can hear me perfectly, so it's time to go. So there's all kinds of known issues and stuff. We're definitely going to encounter bugs. This is a play test, so I'm going to be a male because I am. I don't want to presume to be a female, but they're all kind of skinny. Why don't we say we go ahead and enter the world, see what's happening here. Alright, we already start with an error, so no deployments available. Alright. Oh, and there goes the game. Let me try that again. Hopefully we're going to have a stream here. What up, Kronos, the civil savage? And what up, Mad Dog? Hello. And what up, Axiom of Kronos? We have two different Kronos here. Okay, so the first time we tried to enter this, it failed. So this is all on one big server. It's all one world. Well, there's one for Europe and one for North America. So let's try again. And hopefully we can get a deployment. Yes, here we are. So we're going to do U.S. I am U.S. West. I am here in California, and there's a big rainstorm right now. I guess I can start with the East Coast. Hopefully that will work out. I really want a U.S. West here. And let's see. Can I get out of this? No, I can't. I'm going to go ahead, join the East, and then I guess when we get serious, we can join the West. So a bunch of my server mates and I, a bunch of my server mates want to play this as well. Unfortunately, not everybody got into the registration that was like more than a month ago in time, but there's going to be a closed beta coming up. So in my description, there is a link to register for that. And they're keeping all this playtesting closed, I guess, so they don't get too much grief from folks. More folks joining the stream. Black Fox, Christian Beck. No, I'm just streaming on YouTube right now. I've tried doing the dual streaming. It doesn't always work out for me. And I don't stream very often, actually. So I'm just going to stay focused. Ooh. Here I am, in game. And there's a little bug up there. A little bug. Yeah, so it's not a hyper-realistic game, but I appreciate the art style. And I've got things to learn already, so let's press F1 and show the controls. Whoop, which I also have mapped to turn off my mic. Let's see if that works. Yeah, give me a second. I gotta remap my mic shortcut here. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back now. Now we can safely press... once I get in the game. Oh, and I've already given it away. I have a grappling hook. And shift pulls me up. And control lets me down. That much I know already. And this whole world is physics-based. So theoretically, I could grab onto this bug. Yep. And it would pull me around. Hello, bug. Let's go on a ride. And while I'm hanging from this bug, let's look at the controls. So I've got WASD. My right is my grapple. And... I already said your name, Blazy Ninja. I don't know you more than that, so... let me see. Left click is use the item in hand. Shift, we know, reels us in. Control lets us down. Space is a little, is either a jump, grapple boost, or the ship up. Tab is the menu. E is interact. And Z is rotate held ship. Sit down, climb, hot bar. All right, that's a lot of stuff to remember, but it's not too bad. See, the main one I'll need to remember is X and Q. I think that's a new one. So we need to get out the door here. I think you can swing on this. Woo! Yeah, let's get in there. Can I get that? Oh, not quite. So it's going to take me a while to get decent at this. And one of the things that the devs said is that there's no actual leveling up in this game. It is just skill-based. So how good you are has to do with just how good you are, not, you know, your traditional leveling. I think we can make this go away for now. We find the bug, do that. Cool. And you can see now, we are on an island, and we need to get resources. This island may or may not have been raided by other players yet. Oh, and those are mantas. They want to kill me. And it looks like some players have already been here. Someone's making a ship. Yeah, so those mantas are hostile. And apparently, especially once you make a ship, they will try to attack your ship. Makes things a little bit more challenging. So acquire knowledge. To learn how to build ships, study shipbuilding in the knowledge tree in your tab menu. Knowledge can be acquired by using your scanner. 4 on ancient technology stuff. So I've got 1, 2. That's my gauntlet repair mode. That's my salvage mode. I think I can shoot things with that. And this is my lift mode. And that's my scanner. Okay, so most of those are for building ships. This first one, I don't see anybody around. I can go ahead and and harvest things. Hopefully I didn't mess up his shipbuilding over there. But yeah, everything in here has physics. So you can move things around, or they can move you around. And even when you're harvesting stuff, like if this tree was on the edge of the island, it would have fallen off. And there it was pushing me around a little bit. So I can gather wood. We'll check out tab in a second. Always starts with gathering wood, right? I'm pretty excited about this game. As soon as the rest of my buddies can get it, we're gonna all be in an alliance. I already formed the alliance, or started it, called the Flying Iron, for Iron Mine, which is the name of our server. I guess I still gotta get all the pieces here. And then within an alliance, you can form a crew, and you can all keep respawning on your ship. I don't think there's any like actual base building. Oops. I'm not trying to mess with your ship builder here. So you can see, let me see if I can clean up my mess, and then we will somewhere here the rest of that tree. Alright, up, oh, there it is. Maybe. There we go. All nice and tidy. So let's look in tab and see what we got. So, pistol bullets. Do I have them? Oh, this is my inventory. Oh, I have a gun. Wow. How do I equip that? And I got that wood I just harvested. And I have these. Do I put it here? Oh, look at that. How many bullets do I have? I have 30 bullets. So normally I thought that's something you have to learn. But I guess since this is a play test, they gave me some to start with. And they just introduced food in this one. There was no food before. And everything I know is just from watching people, watching videos and streams. So schematics, we got character. So this is got my grappling hook, a logbook, gear, got some engineer's apron, and skyfarer's shorts. Pretty cool. Yeah, at least I don't have to punch it. I come equipped with a laser. You start with lasers. So, okay, there's me, and there's my schematics. Oh, and these are things that I can build, I think. So, okay, so multi-tool. Okay, so I know how to make bullets, and I know how to make a pistol. So if I lose this one, I guess if I get the required stuff, I can build it again. Assembly station. Why you no do nothing? Shipyard. Huh. Well, I know I'm supposed to make an assembly station in order to make everything else. But I don't know how to do that yet. But I don't have anything to make stuff with anyway. These things in front of me, they're shipyards. And these are all the different ships I can make right now. And then knowledge I have to gain. There's a knowledge tree here. So to make, have engines, I need to find the knowledge and learn them, or cannons or wings. I probably just can make a very rudimentary ship right now. Have no crew yet, because none of my buddies are playing here yet. We might meet someone in game, but I have no idea how to chat, except I think it said enter. And then codex, diary. Okay. So there we are, and I guess there's a day-night cycle. And there's someone named Gopher here. I wonder if he's going to try to kill me. Hello, Gopher. How you doing, man? He's running away from me, maybe? I mean you no harm. Oh, I wonder, is this an assembly station? Press E. Try to interact with it. Getting a ding, ding, ding. I don't know what that is. I guess this is nothing. Stuff in the game that's just like props and terrain. And then there's stuff that you can actually interact with. Hello! he's going to. What's he doing? He's doing stuff with it. Check it out. How did he do that? So, do I press 4? No. Oh. Wait, something happened there. One of the reasons I'm streaming this is because I have no idea what I'm doing. So, oh. An ancient databank contains fragmented information on Saborian technology. Okay. So, guess I'm doing the right thing. Learn how to build skyships. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I've got that equipped. And I am connected. Okay. So hopefully we did something with that. There's people running around all over here. There's a tree floating in the air. And can I connect to this one? I think I kind of have to aim for the little guys, or what? Do I already have this knowledge, maybe? Guess so. There's other knowledge things, too, that... Oh, I got something. I gained 25 knowledge. All right. 25 knowledge. We have it. So, any of you all out there interested in this game, have you heard of it before? Are you waiting eagerly, or you're just like, what the heck is this? But I have high hopes for this game being a real fun sandbox. What was that thing? Are you bad? Are you neutral? Are you just kind of cool and weird? Ooh. I think I don't want to get near that mouth part. Pretty sure about that. So let's do a little grappling practice maybe and see if we can find some resources. The problem with all these people being on this island already, they've probably got all the goodies. The main thing besides wood I know I want to find is ore, which looks like that. Hey, I found some. So I think I gotta put my one, my salvage mode. And these things are like Easter eggs. You gotta kinda crack that stuff off the outside. Really hard to do while you're swinging. And those little black nubs on the outside of that thing in the middle is what I want. Those are the metal ore. But first I gotta get this casing off. Gotta peel the surprise. Okay, let's see if we can go for one of those. Whoa! Oh, you've heard of it, and it looks like your bag. Yes, indeed. Oop, that's the wrong way. So, let's see. What did we get? I missed it. Something. Titanium. Hey, that must be pretty good, right? Woo, we're getting all kinds of titanium. I know there's lead and bronze and copper. Must be iron, right? And they have different abilities when you make the ship. Like, I think a lot of the ship parts can be made out of a lot of different kinds of metal, but it will affect the quality of your ship. Like, you can make it out of lead, but then it'll be made out of lead, which of course would be kind of heavy, I assume. It doesn't want to let me have that little triangle thing. And did I get all the goodies off this? Now, if I don't catch on, I'm going to fall to my death. Which, at this point, is starting to have some consequence, because I will lose my wood, my titanium, and actually I'll lose my free pistol, too. So, a little hairy that you have to do all this suspended like that. Like, so I know already that those are fuel. And fuel's not going to do me a whole lot of good until I have engines. Ooh, that's scary. And I think when you're swinging... See, let's try this. But go... Ooh, this way. If I press space, I get a little boost. Excuse me for a second there. A little congested today, so apologize for that. Alright, there's some more stuff. Let's get it. And this is not the game to play. You have a fear of heights. That was the wrong thing to press. Okay, where'd it go? It's over there. Oop. Reel in. Let's get it. I'm surprised there's still stuff here with all these people running around. Now these things, I think, do respawn. All these islands are either procedurally generated or they're made by players. I actually did a video where I started playing with the island creator thing. And so you can have user-generated content in here. Not all the content you make will be accepted, but I think theoretically a dev will check it out, and if they like it, they'll load it into the world, and your island creation will be part of the persistent universe, which is pretty cool. I like that part. But these parts, the ore and stuff, ooh, that was something. And I can't have it. These parts, the ore and stuff, I think those just spawn on here. You can't add those when you're using... Woo! So it's going to take some time to get a little skill with this thing. But pretty soon, I will be swinging like nuts. Oh, and it's stuck there. I am a monkey, after all. So this should be right up my alley. That one looks harvested. And you can see how the little circle changes when I can actually grapple something. See, if I let myself down, get some more momentum. Well, I don't want to let go when it's not like that. Because otherwise, we'll be at nothing. You can see another island off there in the distance. Dude, but I have no way to get to that yet. Until I can make a ship. Wrong key. I don't want to go up. So, I wonder. I'm going to play for a couple hours now. I have no idea. Oh, and you can hurt yourself hitting stuff too. I have no idea if I'm going to be able to get this shipbuilding in this amount of time. This is definitely a new swing to harvesting resources here. I have to be able to do it like this. Hopefully I'm not making you all dizzy. I'm making myself a little bit dizzy. I'm just trying to get those little black nodules on the outside. Because if I hit that middle thing, it will break. I can see it starting to take some damage there already. And if it breaks, they all just go falling down. I think I cleared it off. And that's about to go. Should we blow it up? I think you're actually supposed to blow them up in the end because that facilitates them respawning. There's an island over there. Oh, someone's building a ship. That's a little dome or circle sphere that forms when you're building a ship. There's another island over there. What's our inventory look now? Look like? We've got 150 titanium, 150 aluminum, 150 bronze. We are balling. Look at that. We got heck of stuff. Alright, so do I escape out of this? X out of it. Alright, let's do a bit more here on the bottom of this island. See if we get some more stuff. Ah! Get a longer swing going. And then we'll go up there and see what we can build. And hopefully nobody will mess with us. Process. I don't know what those little dings are I'm getting. Let's be a good guy here and clean up this. When you pull in, it actually gives you some momentum that's causing that crazy swinging. I'm not sure if that's the bug or not. Ugh. One's cleaned out, so... Oh, it's got that... Oh, this is the one I did. I can't seem to get that thing. There's some sort of float stone or... I forget what it's called. Float stone's the wrong word. That's from modded Ark. From the Flying Rafts mod. There's some kind of floaty stuff I'm supposed to get, too. That's fuel. See another ore thing over here. Alright, that's pretty close. Ding. Dings, anyway. Alright, stop moving. Yeah. I'm sure eventually I'll get really good at this and I'll, like, know how to not swing and stuff like that. I feel kind of sticky when I get close to things. Must have some grippy shoes. Right. Well, that was nickel. Oh, I pressed E. I got it. What was that? Oh no. That was Atlas Shard. That's what I need to get lift. Okay, and I press E to pick them up. I don't shoot them. So you make these flotation cores that go on your ship that make it float. And it takes those. So we just learned something. Cool. I think I'm gonna need to get to the other side of this thing. You can't reel in too fast or it starts you swinging like that. Yeah. If I hit the side too hard, I could potentially kill myself. Alright. And we'll blow it up. There we go. Alright. So let's move along here. See if there's any more goodies to be found down here. There is. Let's just get a bit more, because that will give us more options. But we don't want to get too greedy. Because that might happen. I'm a very novice grappler. And I press the WASD keys when I'm swinging. Seems to actually give me momentum. Ooh. I didn't try the climbing yet. Apparently you can. What was that, the Q key? Alright, let's get aim. Get up close to this thing. Now this one looks a little different, doesn't it? A little tedious getting materials, but it's not too bad. I don't know how far these go. I feel like I'm getting a lot of stuff. Already done some damage to that central core thing there. I get to the point where I'm in my airship. But I have no idea if we'll get there today or not. But my main goal today really is just to kind of mess around and see how this game works. Get a feel for it, start to get an idea of what I'm doing. Learn its mechanics. And make myself dizzy. I'm gonna blow this thing up accidentally. Yep, there we go. Alright. Are we done with this? Let's go for that last one right there. And then we'll see if I can figure out how to get us back up on top of the island. Oh, that's gonna be the way up right there. I feel like I'm getting a little better at this already. For anybody who just came into the stream, didn't read the title, we are playing Worlds Adrift. This is the 6.0 alpha playtest of it. So, I signed up and was accepted to be one of the people checking it out right now. So it is an MMO, so it is full of other players who can all interact, who can possibly kill me if they wanted to and take all my work that I just harvested. So far, the people I've seen have been pretty nice. Or if they wanted to kill me, they didn't realize it. Or they didn't realize they could. It's freaky to ungravel. I'll tell you that. Yeah, so everything that happens here stays. Like if when I was harvesting that wood, if I left it there, it would just be there. And the next person came. Ooh, I heard something go boom. Somebody's shooting cannons already or something. Holy moly. What the heck? There's war already. Alright, I don't want to be down here during the war. Although, yo. Okay, apparently the stream went offline. Sorry guys, but it's back now. And people are cussing and shooting at each other here. So that's the spawner chamber. Hope you guys are still there. I just finished doing some harvesting down there and I heard this booming happen. And I think people are shooting at each other. There's that ship over there. It looks like they have guns on it. The whole island was shaking. Going boom. Boom. So, excellent. We're back. Thing about streaming. Sometimes that happens. Alright, so I guess for folks tuning in, this is now part two of my first gameplay on Worlds Adrift. I'm just checking it out for the first time. If you want the full scoop, the full intro, watch the episode before this. I'm going to put all these up online, video on demand as soon as I'm done doing this and I can go take a look at them, clean them up a little bit. So I'm afraid of going over there now because these people were not being civil. Now let's see what I need to do if I want to make my own ship. Can we do it? I know we got to make an assembly station. We got to make a shipyard. How do I do that? This just says bullets. I don't want to make bullets. Fill in this pistol. That's how I'd make a pistol. Good. That's how I'd make bullets. Bullets just take metal. Oh, gosh. Get out of here. Don't shoot me. Hopefully they're shooting at each other. I'm just a noob. Oh. Oh, they're shooting the mantas. That's awfully close to me. That guy right there. Did he kill it? I thought I saw it fall. I wonder if I can harvest anything from a manta. How do I make that acquire knowledge thing go away? I guess I don't have the knowledge yet to do the assembly thing, huh? Oh no, 2 out of 76. Oh, look, they're trying to move. They're taking off. That's cool. If they're gone, I can just use their shipyard. There's one right there, actually. Oh, there's two of them. If I can just do those. I wonder, can I do more knowledge? Hello! Keeps telling me to get knowledge. What else do I gotta do? Can I press E to interact? Yeah, I'm a total noob right now. And I'm not getting where it shows me how to build the assembly station. Alright, let's live scarily and see if these guys have an assembly station. You can see they've got a ramshackle ship that they've been putting together there. Spence dirt doesn't seem to be too hostile to me yet. Could have shot me before if he wanted to. Oh, there he goes. He's got engines. He's starting it up. He's on his way somewhere. I think that's the core, the flotation core, or whatever it's called, that is keeping this whole thing aloft. He kind of sputs, and doesn't go very far. Knowledge tab. Maybe be fun. Yeah, here. Ship building. Use 20 knowledge to discover ship building and unlock schematics. Okay. You want to purchase that. Okay. Oh! You're a genius, man. You're a genius. So I purchased stuff, and that's for shipbuilding. I'm pretty sure that the assembly station... Oh, here we go. Oh, did I just make it inside? Just in myself? Basics. Sale, personal... Okay, so this is where I make the parts to make this stuff. I can make one of these. I have one shard. Check that out. So sails needs wood. Personal reviver needs metal. Helm. That's excellent. Thank you, man. He got me going here. And then in here, what else can I do? Engines, wings, cannons. Engines will go a lot faster. I don't have enough knowledge. Nope. And nope. Okay, cool. Well, we're getting somewhere. But we can start to build a ship, maybe. Here's someone doing it right now. When you're in progress, you get this protective bubble. Can I go in it? Yep. And as you're building, so it builds a basic frame, and then you attach the parts, like the mast and these panels and stuff like that. Yeah, B-Fun had an awesome setup. The cave. Oop, I'm in caps lock. Hello. Just looking. Oh wow, look, he's making something. Check that out. So oh, he's making his flotation core thing. And then I think when it's done, it's just gonna fall. You're not supposed to be under it, or it can kill you, like, by falling on you. And then he's gotta pick it up, put it on his ship. And then that's what's gonna allow that thing to float. And then a sail is propulsion. That's like early propulsion without, before you have engines. Pretty cool. He's making a very simple basic ship. And this also, this little sphere gives you a way to get up on the ship. Stuff like that. So that's pretty handy as well. Now this thing, what is this? I thought this was the assembly station and I had to make one. I don't want to take his. Been nice enough to not attack me. What's this? Oh, that's his chest. Oh no, it's an empty chest. This is my stuff. And this is what's in the chest. Okay. Oh wow, he just closed his little thing. Alright. Here's one of these again. I wonder if I could, like, pick it up and take it. Oh, apparently not. All right, so we're gonna build I'm gonna pick this one over here, maybe. This guy is busy. Any other ones? Oh, look at that. Oh my goodness. That's somebody's engine. They lost. I wonder, can we salvage from that? I think you can. Oops. Wrong thing. Try that. Oh, look at that. I got all that stuff. Oh, fantastic. Somebody's lost engine. I think we already tried this thing. We want to build there, but that's awfully close to that guy, and he pretty much legitimately got there first. Looks like some Treasure Planet stuff. Oh, I did see that cartoon. I liked it a lot. So if I can't grapple onto it, that must mean... Oh, there we go. I've already gained knowledge from scanning that. Okay. And there's a crafter over there. Let's see. How about this one? We're gonna make a ship. There we go. This one looks available. Where that guy just was. Did he take off already? Oh, cool. Alright, let's see what we need. Alright. Well, let's press E. Oh no, this is still private. It's got a code. So I can't use it, I think, until it's been abandoned a certain amount of time. I think I should be able to craft one of those myself. And then they get left behind for other people to use. See. How about this one? Oh! He wasn't shooting at me, was he? Hopefully that was just dust from my heels. How about here? Does this one have a code? It does. Alright, how do I make my own? If I made my own, where would I make it? I kind of want them up high, so your ship is out of the way. I want to be near one of these crafty things. Looks like I could use this thing, though. Right? Yeah, that's free to use. So, how do I make my own shipbuilding thing? Go up here. See if I can do that. Hey, Keith Detector, when is the next Ragna video? I actually have it recorded already, but obviously right now I'm not editing like I should be. I'm playing this instead. So, assembly station. You can make sails and helms. Shipyard. How do I make the shipyard? I think that would be pretty straightforward. Anybody know how to make a shipyard? Knowledge. I don't think I have enough knowledge yet. I want crew. Thematics. Storage. I can make a barrel. I can make a deck and a small panel. I can make a sky core. I can make a helm. This is a respawner and a sail. Go to a crafting station to craft this item. Yep. I wonder, can I make one at the crafting station? Yeah. Someone should Google for me out there how to make a shipyard. Oh, you have your own server on Ragnarok too. A great map. Yeah. Yeah, I woke up the next day at Bifon's place, geared up, and did some more exploring. So, as soon as I get that edited, I'll throw it up. And then I got something special for you guys, too, coming out on Saturday morning. Something new. Besides this, which is something new as well. Okay. I don't know how to make my own shipyard yet. I know you can make them. These are locked. I could try to hack it, but I don't think I'll get very far that way. Another one of these things here. Yeah, I'm not gonna move forward in this puzzle until I can make a shipyard. Do you know how to make a shipyard? I don't think he does. Feels like the gamma in this game's turned up a little high, or maybe it's just misty. Yes, please, Kronos. Then I won't have to alt-tab out. And we'll make a ship, and then the game really starts, man, once we can start flying. Meantime, oops, wrong thing. In the meantime, there's a bit more wood. Oh, you can't harvest the stumps. Oh, I got some decat berries. That's food. Oh yeah, look at that. My health is 75 of 100. How do I use these? I gotta put them here. Wanna press 8? Do I eat one? Gotta get out of here. You can't escape out of here. Seems like you have to X. Oh, look at that. Oh, and I'm healing. There we go. Eat and heal. Looks like I'm still healing. Didn't check this one because that other guy was here. See if this one is locked too. I bet it is. I have taken ownership of it. Haha, we've got one. All right. Lex schematic, and there's my code, 8308. Let's write that down. 8308. All right, that one was gone long enough. Okay, so we're gonna make the smallest ship possible to start with. We're just gonna make a dinghy, and we just need some wood right there. Oh, I don't have enough wood. Okay. And then, what should we make it out of? Can we mix metals? I don't think we can. I think the deal is you could make it out of any metal, but you can't mix them. So the only one I have enough of would be bronze. It feels like titanium would be better, but the bronze is going to be. The wood should be no problem. So let's find us some wood. Oh, look, wood. That wasn't hard. Okay. Need to craft and place the Atlas core. And that gives me a shipyard? Is that the deal? Yeah, this is a strange looking game. You know, and every island is going to be different. And if you go to Steam, and not just the Worlds Adrift game, but the Worlds Adrift Island Creator, you will see tons of different islands that the community has made. And they get really, really imaginative, and people make little dungeons and castles and things to explore with loot chests and stuff. So, there aren't too many monsters yet. I think those mantas are the main ones, and I think they're not really a problem until you actually have a ship. And then they get real mad at you. This is a panel for a ship we could put on. I wonder. Then we... Bullet is too heavy. Yeah. I think once we start building... Oh, look, there's a model of our dinghy. Once we start building, we can move stuff. Or can I do it now? I think I have to be in thing. That's the repair. That's the lift. Oh, look, I can move it. Not? I don't know how to make it stay. It was left click to get that thing, that ghost image. Right click just grapples. Escape? No. Oh. Maybe I have to have the thing activated. Part needs to be within active shipyard's radius. Okay. Well, we've got the wood for that now. So let's get in there. Hopefully that little creature is not going to hurt me. Hello. Okay. So click edit to customize the shape of your ship. I know once we get it going, we're going to get this little model here. I pressed edit. No? Okay, so next time I need a shipyard, I need to craft and place the Atlas core. Thank you very much. That's what I needed to know. Edits doesn't seem to be doing anything here. Save. Got all the stuff in, right? Got enough bronze. And this, that's there. I can craft it. I guess we'll go ahead and craft. I know there's a mode where you can see like a little wireframe of it on that little stand there, and you can do stuff with it. But that's not doing anything. Let's press that. Oh! So we're just going to get the stock model this time. We didn't see the wireframe. That's alright. I don't know enough to really change it anyway, but you can completely customize the shape of it. But it's building it right now. There is our first ship. Get all this grass out of my way. Right on. There it is. It's ours. It's beautiful. It's a ship. Can I do this thing yet now? This one, right? And they go on the ship. Ways you can, like, place them. I think that is like a deck panel. And I already have some. I'm assuming it'll go green if I could place it. Oh, look at that. It's stuck. No, it didn't. Right on. Let's just get that out the way. I don't think we need it right now. So our shipyard is active. I'm not seeing the sphere around it, though. It allows you to, like, grapple on. Let's see what's in here now. Ship is currently docked to the shipyard, so I can't make a new ship. Right. That's fine. Lockbox. Interesting. Okay. So, let's make some things to put on it. We're definitely going to need a core. Atlas Sky Core. So let's use our one shard that we have. We need 100 more metal. So, and then it needs a generator. What's this? This is more bronze. We got a lot of bronze. And I don't know if the matters. What's my cheapest metal here? If I put lead there, it took the lead for the generator. And then I need 100 of something. Use nickel. The casing. I don't know how that affects. Oh, it has 70 kilograms. If we took that back out and used titanium. Okay, it's much lighter. I don't know if that's what I want to use my titanium for. And what if we did aluminum? It's fully aluminum and it's much lighter. Sure, what the heck. Let's craft it. It's doing it. Oh yeah. Let's get out of here. Away from it before it falls on me. Now, if you get into an air battle and someone shoots this, your ship falls. That's that. Now I can pick this up. Yes. And place it up there. Alright. So now this thing is actually going to be able to float. I want to get it nicely centered. Hard to tell what's going on. Apparently there's a first person mode too, and that's not it. What's the controls? It doesn't say how to do first person mode, but you can go from third to first. Supposed to be easier to use to place the parts if you go into first person mode, but I don't see it at all. I can sit down, take a little rest. Alright, no time for sitting down. We have a ship to build. Yeah, it may. I mean, I think weight is definitely important for sure. It affects, I think for engines, it will definitely affect the speed of them. Maybe the fuel efficiency. We'll find out. We'll be experts in this soon enough. Alright, so go ahead and put this on. We won't worry too much about perfection. Down there at the bottom, it would be very vulnerable. In here, it might get in the way. Can't tell if that's centered. Woo, but it's there. Good enough. Alright, so we can float. Next thing. Let's do the basics. We need a helm. So we need more wood. We got that. And then something we have 20 of. Iron for the flight stick. That seems reasonable. Got lead. Alright, let's do iron for the flight stick and bronze for that. And let's craft it. Oh yeah. We're making that. Oh, and that time I actually was able to escape out of it. Cool. Oh, and I do have a circle around here. So I can go up, get on my ship for the first time. See if we can get up here and then select our helm. What's my helm? Alright, yeah, that's a much better place to place it from. Alright. We're making our first ship. Excellent. Look at that. I got my little piece of ribbon to tell which way the wind's blowing. Press E. I am at the helm. All right. Oh, oh, oh. I'm flying. No, no. Go down. It was flying. Because it's got the flotation core. So it can do that. But we're not ready yet. Whoa! Stop it. Stop moving. Wait, how do I go down? Let's see. Base took me up. What's to go down? Ah, control. Okay. I think if you get within a certain distance of... Oh, the mantas are after me. Certain distance of your dock, you'll get auto docking. Maybe. Is that docked? I don't think so, somehow. And I still... No, it's not docked. I know you can redock. And then, yeah, I don't have my little circle up there anymore. Can I grab my helm? Get me back up there. Okay. Let's try this again. I think I was being attacked by a... Oh! Was that it? I think I docked. I did. Okay. I was afraid that was a manta attacking me, but no, that's what happens if you're redocked. Good, good, good. All right.
Oh,
ow. Let's keep going with this. What else do we need? Basics. Sail. Let's make a sail. Oh, I need to gather a bunch more wood. And then this is the respawner. We've got metal for that. We're good. And with a sail and a respawner, we'll be good to go. We don't have guns yet, so, oh, and a barrel is storage. We probably want that, so I don't have to carry all my stuff, so if I fall, I won't lose it all. So, let's do some more deforestation. Get the salvage tool going. Check it out, you can, I think you can affect how these fall. Slice it up. Take it. Oh, there we go. We can see the effect of my shipyard. We're gonna get airborne, guys. We're gonna do it. For sure. Yeah, I'm so glad I'm streaming this, because there's no way I could fit this into an episode the first time. Now that I know what I'm doing, sort of. Pros. It was stuck on the actual sphere. Ooh. Oh, and there's different kinds of wood, too, that probably have, like, different properties. This is elm. Come on, I got some berries. We're staying in the food. Yeah, so we gotta go exploring and check out some other islands, get some more knowledge. And then there's different areas that are sort of, what's the word I'm looking for? Surrounded by storm walls. And you can't get your ship out past the storm wall until it's strong enough to do it. And this is just a frame I've got. There's all kinds of metal plating or wood plating and stuff that you can put on it, and engines. But there's no way you're getting through the storm wall until, I think that's a storm wall right there. Pretty sure there's no way you're getting through until you got engines and metal plating and all that kind of stuff. So we're sort of confined to the area within the storm wall. Need that right now. Okay, so let's make some more stuff. Do so the sail. We got enough? We do. Just enough. So let's make us a sail. Alright, the dinghy is coming together. It's a fine sail. Alright, let's get up there. Bang ourselves against some things first. Let's see, we want number 3, right? Yeah. Get our sail. place it up here. So the number of sails affects speed and performance. This is not a very big ship. So hopefully... good. Can we make two sails, maybe? See if we can put one in the corner. Make another one. That will really speed up our journey, too. I should really use my thing for that. Oh, look, some more wood. Oh, wrong tool. We're getting this down. Getting it. Okay. Probably shouldn't stand downhill from it. Where'd it go? Getting all kinds of berries incidentally while I do this. Ooh, there it goes. Somewhere down there. You know, I probably should stick to the same kind of wood. So my two sails don't have different performance. Like, I think where you put the engines and stuff actually affects how the ship flies. So if you put them at weird angles, you'll like spin in circles or whatever. Okay, can we make another sail? Oh, not quite. Or elm. Pretty soon, guys, we will be masters of the sky. Well, like any game, it's a little grindy. Oh! What the heck? I got hurt. Oh, a tree hit me. Alright. Time to eat some berries. See how far that gets us. Alright, be careful when you're harvesting. I'm glad I didn't die. Careful. Alright, how are we doing? We have enough elm. Cool. And... I want to get a bit more wood because I know I'm going to need a barrel. And there's going to be some wood for that, I'm pretty sure. Let's do one more tree and see if that's enough to get us out of here. A little rubber banding there. Apparently they're using an engine that is based all around network performance, so it's meant for an MMO, but they're still struggling a little bit with lag, especially when the ship is in motion. Kind of like a raft in Ark, where other players can get thrown off with the raft while it's in motion, so you're supposed to grapple on. Gonna have to get a PC. Yeah, and this is just the bare alpha. It's gonna get really cool once we get up there. Everybody loves airships. Okay. So let's make our second sail. We're gonna... oh, look at how much elm we have. Craft it. And then... yeah, you can only make one thing at a time. Let's see if we can just make all our parts and leave them here on the ground and then go up and put them on. If I was really on it, I'd make like panels to cut. cover up around my sky core there. There it goes. So that it'd be hard for people to shoot it, but I don't think we're going to do all that this time. We're just going to be vulnerable. And we're going to put caution to the wind. We definitely need this. This is how we respawn, and this is what makes this boat our home. So we got to just put any kind of metal in here. And I guess it does affect the weight. Saving my titanium. Oh, it says the qualities here. Versatile and medium weight. A few weaknesses. Extraordinary light. Yeah. But a bad conductor. Yeah, I want to build a ship, I think, out of titanium. Let's do our reviver out of nickel, I guess. Okay, and let's craft that. And then the last thing I think we need is the barrel, and we'll be ready to take flight. Okay, there's my respawner. I fell on top of there. And then one more thing. Oh, so yeah, these are the decks and the panels. Make a barrel. I'll take some wood. And hoops, the chime hoop. And what do we have 20 of? Ooh, let's make a brass barrel. What the heck? What is the quality of brass anyway? Withstands a lot of stress for its medium weight, but not resistant to heat. I don't know if it matters for a barrel. Okay, craft. Good thing we found all that metal down there. You'd be stuck. If you don't have enough resources on an island, I don't know how you get off. Wait to hitch a ride from somebody. Okay, so let's get up there. Not hurt ourselves. Okay, and then it was 3. Get the other sail. Look at that. We're going to have dual sails from the get-go. That should definitely increase our speed from what I've seen. Alright, and then there's our other stuff. There's our barrel. I'm just going to keep everything here on the top deck because it's hard to go from the upper deck to the lower deck. They're going to make some ramps or something at some point, but those aren't in the game yet, I don't think. Really, I think I want like a barrel, and a spawner. So let's plan for that. And then the spawner was sitting there on top of the thingy too. Oh! Not quite. Get back up. Looking like something. One of these days I'll know what those dings are. Saw it? There it is. Okay, let's put our spawner on. The second center. Hello, temple guard. How are you? Alright, I think we're ready to go. E to interact. So we can put our stuff in the barrel if we want. And how much it holds. Oh, not a whole lot. Yeah, we do need another barrel. Let's put some stuff in there. Gotta kind of arrange your stuff, I guess. It doesn't fit, it can't go in. Yep. We need more storage, for sure. Okay. One more barrel. We're out of here. Ah! Keep doing that. Grass. Wood. Craft. Yeah, decking's the thing we're... or paneling's the thing we're missing. And I think we're gonna do okay. Hopefully we won't get attacked. If we get attacked, we're sitting ducks anyway, because, we don't have any guns. Although, I guess defense would be... a pretty good idea. But you guys don't want to see me on this island forever doing that. We want to fly. Okay. There's our other storage. Right there. Then I can put this stuff in it. Now if I die, I won't lose all this. I wish there's some way to make that go up in there, but oh, nope. And some wood. Oh, look at all that food I've got. Maybe we could store some food in here. Have some food afterwards if I die too. Loaded with food. Okay. Excellent. I haven't even tried my gun yet. Apparently I have it loaded right now. I don't want to fire it off with that guy there. Alright. I think I am ready to go. That's excellent. So, with no further ado, let's take control of our ship. So let me look at the controls one more time. So space is ship up. It's also shift. And control is down. And then it's WASD for all of that stuff. Okay. So let's press space. All right. And let's go. Now, what I don't think I have is third person mode. Ooh. Get out of there. The direction of the wind does matter with sails. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay. Easy there. I think it's self-leveling. We don't want to fall off at this point. If I die, I could respawn. I just lose my gun at this point. Let's make a plan. The wind's blowing that way. Is there anything cool over there? There's that island. Go check that out. There's that one. Those guys over there. That's a storm wall. So we don't want to get into that just yet. Ooh. Oh, it redocked. Look at that. It just takes a little while. Alright, so as long as the wind's blowing that way, I say we head for, where was that really interesting one? I think it's lost in the clouds already. Oh look, somebody else making a ship. Oh, I lost a sail already? Oh man, thank you. Where'd it go? I must have hit it against that thing when I went up there. Alright, well I guess it's a good thing we're docked. Oh, there it is. Thank you guys for looking out for me there. And how is it? There was a repair tool. And was it? No, it was that one. Let's make those go away. Requires elm log to repair. Didn't quite see where the readout was, if how damaged it was or not, but I assume so. What I was missing when I started to fly was third person mode so I can see what the heck I'm doing. I think you're constrained to first person when you're flying, and so also how you design the ship is really important so you can see where you're going, which gets really tricky when you're trying to like also be defensive, protect yourself. And you notice the sail wanted the same kind of wood that it was made out of before. The maiden voyage of the flying Megapithecus. Indeed. Alright, can we repair you now? All right. Where's the readout on how broken it is? I don't know. Let's hope it's good enough. And oh, my health is pretty bad too. So let's get some more berries down in there. And X out of there. Eat a berry. Okay. And then let's try this again. Oops. And again. Okay, we want 3. I guess that's the problem with having 2 sails. There's 2 sails to break. Look at that over there, that guy to the left. He's playing. He got the wireframe working, I guess. And he is choosing. Oh no, he's just going between the different stock designs. Cool. I'd go check it out, but at this point, I don't want to risk any issues. Alright, so let's plan our voyage. I gotta be careful going up too high, because I'll hit that respawn room. And we want to go there, I think. We're just going to go up a little bit, and then we're going to bank to the right. Okay, let's see if I can do this. Here we go. Second maiden voyage of the flying Megapithecus. Here we go. Okay, so space. All right, not too much. Go that way. I gotta press W, I guess, to go forward. I wonder how much is this and WASD. Oh, it's trying to dock again. Oh, don't dock. Go forward. Oh, there we go. W doesn't seem to be doing much. But that little ribbon says that the wind is behind my sails. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? Something very important here. I probably want to unfurl my sails. That would help, wouldn't it? Give me a little momentum. Oh, yeah. Check that out. There is the wind right behind us. How beautiful is that? Okay, let's try this again. Oh boy, yeah, now we've got some velocity. Woo. How do I go up? Woohoo! My mouse moves this thing. Aha! I don't know how that relates to the WASD. Woo! We are going. Alright, if I press E now, I'm on my ship. We're flying. Where's the place that we're trying to go to? Oh, Misty. I have no idea. There's the guy who's building the ship. Are we still moving? We are. Holy moly. I think we want to turn before we head into the storm wall. Ooh, it's a little laggy. Not bad. I think I gotta get the hang of this. Now the wind is to our left. Pressing shift to go up. Some elevation. Now there's another island. Right over there. Get a little high. Pressing control to go down. Woohoo! Hoist the sails.
Yeah.
Probably pretty important. So there seems to be a little delay when you press up or down. The effect persists for a while. Got some momentum there. Now we're going against the wind. See if we can get the wind behind us again. Hopefully, eventually they'll put a third-person view in here so you can see what you're doing. There's an island off to the upper right there. You can head towards that. Not exactly the one that I was looking for before. But at this point, anywhere I can get to, good with. Whoa! That happens quick. Probably should keep a grapple on in case I fall off. Ah, there was the one I was trying to get to. Although that one looks a little hard to navigate once you're up there. That one looks a lot more reasonable. That one looks cool. It might be hard. Now the trick is, can I get there? I don't think that's a storm wall. It says the noob captain. We'll see. We've got the wind to our back. Let's head that way. All right. The turning happens quick. W doesn't seem to do a whole lot. I think that must just work mostly with engines. I think with the sails, the momentum I have is the momentum I have. Indeed. It's all about the wind. Pretty sure. I must be moving. Going a little higher. If we get on the level with that island there and seek our fortune. Now there's different controls you can get once you gain some knowledge. Oh, I see. When you do W, it stays. That must be neutral. And backwards? Oh, that would be difficult. So, okay. We'll just leave it forward, and then I don't have to keep holding it. Pretty much on course. Oh, you know what? I wonder... Okay, I'm going higher now. I was wondering if there's a limit to how high you can go based on how many sky cores you have. I'm learning how to pilot this thing. Going up. Probably the distances are larger than they seem. Why it's taking me a while to get there, and it's probably like a really large island. Wonder if there's a key to look back and forth. Now, where did that island go? That's a little worrisome. That's right there. Okay. Ooh, frozen. Keep a grapple on. There's the island where we came from. Back there. I think I can leave the helm and I'm still moving. Yeah. Looks like you can see those little trails for the wind. Mist is definitely moving past us. Oh, yeah. And it's getting closer. Check it out. Got a cave down there. Really starting to see some detail on it now. That's too cool. Alright. Take the helm here so we make sure that we don't run into this place. Get a little higher. So we can come in from above. Not smash the side of it. I think once we get above it, I'm going to have to unfurl the sails real quick. Might actually be pretty level with that grassy plain. Here, why don't we unfurl one sail? I can. We don't have as much speed coming in. Coming real slow. Yeah, and it doesn't seem to make me go sideways. Ooh, it looks like someone else is over there. Alright, I've never docked at an island before. Take our speed down. Still moving. I don't think we're gonna hit it. Okay, let's unfurl the other sail. Nice mechanics. Still moving. Building down there. Can I go down? Do I want to go down? Whoa! It's going down. Well, you know, O'Reilly is building airships because he wants to play this game so bad. He couldn't get in the this alpha, so he's like, okay, I have to add this mod at least. There's somebody over there. Go, hello. I come in peace. And I just want to dock this at the place that I know I can get back onto it. Wonder if I could get back on it now. Looks pretty good. Go down just a hair. Tap that. Get off of it. Oh, slow down. I don't want to break anything. Stop. Hey. What are you? Oh, you're a little fragment. Island, don't break my sail. Stop that. Okay. We need to go up a little bit. So that thing's not breaking the sail. I wonder how you get a reading on the damage. Maybe with your damage tool? We're still going up. Delicate thing. Ship flying. Over here, get away from that little rock. Rock. Then go down a little bit. Oh! Yes. These things don't necessarily come with an anchor. But I think we can actually get off. We have made it to a second island. Look at that, guys. Our good little dinghy has done it. The flying Megapithecus. That's wonderful. Well, before we get killed or anything, let's get some more knowledge. I think it was that one. Not sure what I hit when it decides to connect. Oh, there it is. Did I do it? See, it give me a message that I got some knowledge. Oh wait, that's the wrong thing. That's my scanner. I guess it's actually left click for this. Yeah, I tried to get some more keys for everybody, but because it was limited access to this, they wouldn't let me have more keys. Oh, there we go. 25 knowledge. Got it. They said it would be unfair to give me more keys, so unfortunately, Arali and Aaron BLP and our new guy Monkey Man and SW Chris, they're all having to wait for the next one, the closed beta, which should be coming at least by May, not sooner. But I feel kind of bad being the only one who gets to play it right now. When I signed up for it, I didn't even know much about this game. I didn't know if anybody would have any interest in it. So I just signed up and then learned more about it, and I actually got accepted. It was like right before the deadline too when I saw it. I was just going around looking for new games. I don't know exactly what the trick is to get that connection happening. Now it's left click. I've got the right tool selected. But there it is. Really random. Woohoo, but we got 25 knowledge. Excellent. Hi. If folks are friendly around here. Yeah, that's friendly enough. What's that? I guess that's just a little pile of rocks. Thought that was a campfire or something. Alright, ship, you stay there. I don't know if anyone could take my ship. Or if it's like only belongs to me? Or what? Let's go up there. See if there's more knowledge things. And then see if we can get into that cave that was down below, too. Well, let's try our climb mode. You? There we go. Oh yeah, we're rock climbing. They just added that this patch. Kind of sinking into the rocks, but it's not too bad. We got some other players making some ships up here. See, that's with the paneling. Now I'm afraid for them, with all that paneling in one sail, that it's not going to go very fast. I wonder how much more knowledge we got now. I guess we could learn wings. I've got 80 knowledge. That takes 90. That takes 150. I wonder what wings do for you. Ding. Well, let's keep saving up, because it seems like engines may be more useful. But who knows? I don't know about this stuff yet. That looks like it goes down inside. Eee. I guess I could have just ran down there. Are you resources? think these were little fuel things. But fuel doesn't do us a whole lot of good until we have engine. Just take up inventory a moment. But this one has the fuel. Let's do one. Whoa. Just for kicks. Here we go. We got 25 fuel. This is going to require climbing. Yep. If you can climb down too. Oh, that could be handy. Right on. And none of these islands are even all that interesting. These must be like the procedurally generated ones. The handcrafted ones get pretty cool. Like that one with the really weird shapes that we saw. That was probably a handcrafted one. This looks like Fuel Island. See if we can get over there. Hurting ourselves too bad. Oh, that hurt. It's dark in here too. Well, there's some more metal. Go get that. Kind of good downhill with when you're on a slope. Oh, and this is easy metal. This is the first time we could actually just stand here. Unwrap our present. Oh, and we got another one of those Atlas stones. So we'll need those once we want to make a bigger ship. Got that. Excellent. That's a score. Alright, well, we're moving on right along in this game in my first little test gameplay session. Here, I didn't know how far I'd get. We'd be flying at all. I think we're getting a handle on this. Blow it up so it will respawn. Okay. I wonder what powers my little tool. So far, I don't need to worry about it. There are torches, too, for lighting. They just introduced global illumination. Sounds like someone's taken off. Hopefully, well, not with my ship because it doesn't have engines. What's this stuff? Press E to interact. Oh, it's a chest. What you got? Cracked hydraulic pins. Okay, guess I want those. Is that our first loot chest? To you. Hey, some free wood. Cool. We found some goodies down in here. Okay. Right on. Well, maybe I should get out of here and see what else we can find. Go for another ride on our boat. Oh yeah, there's that place. I think we're going to have to go there.
Oh!
I need to eat some berries pretty soon. One of these days I'll get really good at grappling. Like I said in the beginning, there's no actual character leveling in this game. It's all about your actual skill. That's a little boost I get. But I don't seem to always be able to make it work. But if I'm grappling and I press space, I get that. That's supposed to be helpful to help me get over edges once I figure out what I'm doing. Alright. You get up here? Press boost? No. I think if my feet are off the ground, then I can do it. Oop. All right, derpage. No, not quite. Feet off the ground. Tried to grapple up there. There we go. Maybe. That's hard. There we go. Ooh. Oh look, more stuff. Get it. Yeah, that's gonna require climbing. Can I salvage while I'm climbing? Yes, I can. Ooh. That's a trip. Okay. Not in much control of that. Trying to grab that. There we go. Just a little easier like that. Grab some metal. I can understand the elemental metal in here, but I'm curious how the these different alloys could be in these formations. Things like bronze. That's okay. We'll accept that. And if I blow this up, will it hurt me? No. Speaking of, eat another berry or two. That one, and I wonder if the healing's cumulative. Oh, there's a cooldown. Can't eat another berry right now. With a swing, it's easier. Okay. That's back into the cave. I'm getting homesick for my ship. And worried about it. Oh look, the shadow of me. That's cool. Yeah, so there was no actual character creation yet. Yay, my ship is fine. Let's take a quick peek over here. See if I missed anything. Or knowledge or anything like that. This is a pretty boring island, but it was significant that it was the first one we made it to. Clearly, we did not discover it. Seems like there's like two knowledge things per island. I know there's a limit on them. Alright, back on the ship. Take the helm. You know, these I'm worried about. I'll probably just harvest them because I don't want to hit them on the way out. Although, if they fall on my ship, will they hurt it? That's a very good question. See, we need this thing. I wonder if I can just back out of here. Because that looks like it's just going to fall right on it. We can make a hard right. Yeah. Alright, let me get back up there. Right. Go. Positioned. Then we're moving. Okay, so we're gonna go right for that. Wind's against us. But apparently these things know how to tack on their own. Probably just go a lot slower. Unfurl my sails. Yeah, and they do turn with the wind. That's really cool. Better grab my helm. Things are happening I'm not particularly in control of. There we go. There's our target. That course with a funny looking island. What are y'all thinking? Folks out there who are my viewers, regular viewers, is this a game you'd like to see me play? Some regularity? Is this interesting to you? It'll get even cooler, of course, when I've got some of the other folks with me and interacting with other players. But I'm digging it. I'm really interested to see what I can find on some of these other islands. Uh-oh. That one is unfurled. Oh, it needs to be repaired. Okay. We have elm to you. Your hemlock. Your elm in the chest. The hemlock in here. Can we combine that? No. I guess it's max 150. Store this for you. Oh, fuel. Right. This stuff. That. That. Doubt that's enough elm to repair it. May just have to limp there on one sail. Okay. Berries seem to go a long way. I'm just being real careful about staying latched on. The one I came from. And no, no more elm in here either. Put that there. These there. No place for that to go. Trade these out at least. Big one over there. I don't think I have any weight limits, I just have a space limit myself. So were you the repair guy? No, you are. We can put 6 elm logs into here. Okay. Is that enough to fix it? Yes, it was. Excellent. I like how you can just set course and then just hang out while your ship works its way there. We're gonna have to stay stocked up with elm. Keep these repaired. Oh. That island go. There it is. Right in front of that big storm wall. I wonder how many islands I have access to within here. Time to correct our course a little bit. Not that much. Oop. So Kronos the Civil Savage, one vote for more of this. Worlds Adrift, I'm definitely going to be playing it. And I'd love to share it with you guys as I go. Streaming it seems to be a really good way to do it. As I get better and I have content that I can condense into an episode, we can definitely do that. Little how-tos and stuff, but chill kind of voyage style. Man, it's sensitive. Seems to be a good way to do it for now. Then when I'm done, there's no editing. It's ready to go. Flying Iron will be a force to be reckoned with. Indeed. You should join us too, B-Fun. B-Fun is now the newest member of Iron Mine. Well, him and Monkey Man both are part of the crew. So in here, apparently, there's the Alliance and then there's the crew. The Alliance can be as large as you need it to be, and the crew can be four. So you can have four crew people on a boat. But they can be part of a much larger alliance. I don't know if that means that only four people can ride on a boat. Can't be true, because I know that you can board other ships. And if there was a limit of only four people, you could never board a ship. Yeah, so we'll visit that cool-looking island over there. We'll check it out. And then that will probably be the bulk of what we do for the day. And then we can do this again soon. So mellow and chill as you're sailing up here in the sky. I guess until someone tries to, like, shoot cannons at you or something. Quite a few islands down there, too. Ooh, a little bit of lag. All right. We've had a pretty good game experience so far. Oh, you're already signed up. Excellent. Yeah, so down in the description of this episode, there is a link for registering, and you gotta register to sign up to be part of the next playtest. So this is a test. I don't know how long it's gonna go, whether it's up for a week or up for a month. I have no idea. I'm sure they're gonna add more features as they go along. We're coming in fast. Let me see. Let's take one of the sails down. Get a little height. I'm also on the East Coast server right now, because that was the only one available. I wonder if I then went to a West Coast server, if it would be all new, or if my boat comes with me. I'm pretty sure that I read that the boats despawn after you log out of the game, which prevents offline griefing. A few minutes after you're gone, I think the boat goes away. Yeah, whole flotilla. I'm sure everybody will. This seems to be a pretty captivating game. Someone's harvesting logs. Falling off the side. Yeah, this would be a hard one to harvest on. Definitely got some folks here. Let's pull back on the throttle. If that does anything. Oh, there's a manta. Uh-oh. Manta's coming after me. Is it coming after me? Hope not. Gun ready. I heard they don't like ships. That would be bad. I should get to someplace where I'm docked here. All right. Oh, and look at those things. That thing. Well, let's survey this and see if it's a place we want to stop. They look pretty well populated already. Not a whole... Yeah, let's go. Although we're already halfway to these other ones now, too. I'm gonna go with it. Let's go down to that one. That one looks like it might have some sort of castle or something on it. Yeah, definitely it's for manning a ship. Trying to go down here. Okay, so this, the mouse, definitely controls the tilt of the ship. What's the word for that? The yaw? As opposed to the WASD, which controls the direction. Coming in there. Need to go down some. Ooh, lag. Dangerous lag. Stay anchored. I can see my cord there. I do that. Ooh. I'm not doing that. I think the wind just spun us around. Yo. Oh, man. Uh-oh. Oh, man. My cord broke. And I'm falling. Oh, man. I'm gonna lose my gun. I'm gonna lose my bullets. I'm gonna lose everything that was on me. We're falling. The game did that to me, guys. I was anchored in everything. It threw me off. My cord snapped. Oh my goodness. Oh! You know what I didn't do? Oh wait, I got the personal reviver, right? You know what I didn't do? My respawner on my ship? I was supposed to claim it. Didn't do it. My ship is gone. Well, this might be it for the night then, guys. That was a lesson learned. We were cruising. It was so peaceful. I have just donated my ship to the winds. I wonder if another person can find it. Oh, do I still have my gun? And my berries? Yeah. Oh, you know what? I only have the stuff that was on my hotbar. Okay. So you gotta keep whatever you want to keep when you die on your hotbar. I wonder if I could have put the bullets down here. Interesting. Okay. Well, let's just take a quick look at where we are. I'm not going to do all that over again right now. Yes, we definitely need people to man the guns. Let's figure out where we are in relation to where we lost our ship. Oh, there's one of those bugs. If we recognize anything here, let's get up high. What a peaceful ending, right? Falling into the sunset. Recognize anything? That's the one I was going to, and this one was coming next. Actually, that was the one I think I was headed for. My ship is over there somewhere. I think what happened is I got too close to the storm wall, and then the heavy winds started tossing my ship around. Because it was turning on its own, it was listing. Always claim your respawner. Well, it's not bad. This is the first time I played anyway, so I'm not attached that much, and it really wasn't that hard to make a dinghy. At least we're going for a much grander ship. Be a lot more material gathering, obviously, but we'd have to visit a few islands really in order to have enough materials, I think, to build a thing. But there's some pretty large ones indeed. Get some knowledge while we're here. I also wonder if I go from server to server, if not only my inventory but my knowledge persistence. So that is one thing. This sort of a leveling. But for this, you just have to hold it for a while. Still trying to figure out what the trick is to tether to these things. Hello, buggy. Give me your knowledge. Oh, there it is. All right, got my 25. That's another one. Before, I got it off of that little guy right there. Yay! 25 knowledge. Check out some other people's boats here. The dinghy with panels. I had a boat once. I did. I remember the day when I had my own. This person's doing the dinghy as well. Well, next time we'll know how to make our own shipyard if we need to. After enough people play the map, there are shipyards all over the place. Where's little bugs go? Love to hitch a ride on the bug and fly off that way. Maybe they'll take me to my ship. Ship, which is there somewhere. Apparently, this game has really amazing draw distance, too. You can actually see stuff really far away. So, like, theoretically, I'd be able to see my ship. Oh, is it all at range? There's a bug. Here, bug. Hey, guys. I am at the random fate of where this bug wants to go. Oh! Come back here, bug. You're my ticket out of here. Take me to my ship. Come on, man. You can do it. I trust you. Oh! Alright, folks. I think this is as good of a place as any. Sign out. So thank you for watching. to the very end of this stream. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye, everybody. Thanks for hanging out and helping me out. Look how far I've come. All right. So I'm not sure if I could just sign out like this. Oh, and I don't even have these options right now. Okay. We'll do a random one. Whoa, I'm in here already. Hello, Death 102001. Do I have charts? Oh, like maps of the place? Maybe? I don't think so. I haven't seen anything like that. Oh, we've been here. This was the second island I went to. I wonder if I can... No, I can't. Can I grapple to somebody else? No, I can't. I wonder, can you push somebody off? No, I just walked through him. I could shoot him, but I don't have any bullets. And that would be bad karma anyway. Alright, I think I'll just sign out right here. I'll see you guys in the next one. Yes, exit now. And I'm stopping the stream. Thank you, everybody.